So the first thing, probably I should say, well, I know a lot of people are probably reading this being like, oh, so you made this whole video about how you're done with reaction videos because you want to go off and do your own thing. And the thing you wanted to do was a tier list video. I'm a huge fan of the Star Wars franchise. I mean, growing up, we always had, well, the first three Star Wars movies were always on, it seems like, regularly in our house, although I never really sat down and watched them. You grew up watching them in a way, but you never actually sat down and understood what was going on. That was me. Like, I knew Darth Vader was Luke's father. I knew, like, some of the plot points. I never really sat down to watch Star Wars up until I got my wisdom teeth out a few years back, and I had a marathon and watched all the Star Wars movies while I was lying in bed shoveling applesauce in my mouth. And yeah, now I just recently watched Rise of Skywalker. I want to say very clearly, this is just my opinion. I'm just watching these movies and giving my own opinion, so I don't know if I'm going to say something that's controversial, or it seems like everyone's really split when it comes to a lot of these movies, especially the sequel trilogy. I'll get to those, but I feel like movies like The Last Jedi, The Rise of Skywalker, people seem to be pretty split on what their opinion of them is. Anyways, let's begin. I guess we just jump into it. Okay, so we got the main movies, and then we also have Solo and Rogue One. I'm gonna start with Episode One, just kind of go up from there. So we'll start with the prequels. The Phantom Menace. I think when I first watched these movies, The Phantom Menace and Attack of the Clones, I would have easily said that I enjoyed The Phantom Menace more than Attack of the Clones. And I think going into this list, because I just now, last week, rewatched all the movies, including watching Rise of Skywalker for the first time, because by the time Rise of Skywalker came out, I didn't care anymore. Yeah, before I rewatched the movies, I would have easily said that Phantom Menace, I preferred Phantom Menace over Attack of the Clones, because I hated Attack of the Clones first time I watched it. But rewatching it, I have to say Attack of the Clones is a better movie. I think the problems I have with The Phantom Menace is just a big one. It's the pacing. It's a horribly paced movie. And when you think of Phantom Menace, what's the two things you think of? You obviously think of Darth Maul and the final fight scene, which is amazing. The final fight is not overrated at all. It deserves all the hype, all the praise it has, because it's beautifully But even when we have the fight scene with Darth Maul, it's like it keeps cutting back to Anakin and whatever his little space battle is. So it's like, anytime it's doing something that's interesting, it's like we keep having to cut away to something that's not interesting at all. I don't understand who this movie was geared towards, because it's like George Lucas wrote a plot about trade negotiations, but yet he keeps shoehorning in all this really cringy humor that just doesn't work. Jar Jar Binks never bothered me necessarily. Like, I don't watch The Phantom Menace and say Jar Jar Binks is the reason why The Phantom Menace sucks. There's a lot of things that are wrong with this film, and the main reason is just that it's boring. All the acting is really flat. Ewan McGregor and Liam Neeson are kind of the two standout-ish, but Ewan McGregor, who became like the staple of the prequel trilogy, isn't really that interesting in this movie. He doesn't really do anything. It's not till the second and third when he really gets his chance to shine. The other thing is the CGI. The prequel trilogy is not going to age well over time. You can already see it with The Phantom Menace. It looks horrible at times. It looks like a PlayStation game. Except for the pod race. The pod race surprisingly still holds up really well. And it's still entertaining. See, I know a lot of people tend to nitpick it. I don't know. I enjoyed it. I think it's like the two highlights of the film is the pod race and of course the final duel. But yeah, just how I feel. I just don't feel like the CGI aged well, and I don't feel like it's gonna age well. I don't know. I just, rewatching the film, I think it's easy to say that Attack of the Clones was better, because even though Attack of the Clones has the horrible acting of Hayden Christensen and Natalie Portman, which I don't blame entirely on Hayden Christensen and Natalie Portman. Hayden Christensen is not a great actor, but once again, just like Jar Jar Binks saying that they're the reason why Attack of the Clones was bad, it's not all their fault. The writing is awful. I mean, so give him some credit. There were some things I also liked in Attack of the Clones, and I think for the most part, they kind of evened out. I liked Samuel Jackson, or whatever, Mace Windu, and Yoda actually getting more time to shine. I actually like the lightsaber fight between Yoda and Count Dooku at the end. I know a lot of people seem to criticize and not like Yoda using a lightsaber. I was fine with it. The main issues I really have with Attack of the Clone is just the unnecessary scenes, like the stupid conveyor belt scene, which was just, it's just stupid. There's so many unnecessary just crap thrown in this movie that's just stupid. It's not entertaining, it's not fun, it's just horrible. But a big redeeming factor of this movie, and probably the reason why I enjoyed it more, Ewan McGregor as Obi-Wan, I like the movie focusing more on him getting a little bit more to do in this movie, but also because of Christopher Lee. Since the first time I watched it, I have watched the Hammer films, like the Hammer Dracula films and stuff. I don't know if you guys have watched those before, but they're freaking great. And Christopher Lee is awesome. And maybe unpopular, because I feel like a lot of people as of late kind of prefer episode one over episode two. I prefer episode two. For the record, I don't think they're good movies, either of them, but I do give episode two the edge. Maybe it's just a slight edge, but it's still an edge. Revenge of the Sith. Episode 3 is legitimately really good, in my opinion. I think episode 3 gets a lot of heat. I feel like a lot of people have come to respect it a lot more since the sequel trilogy came out. Not that I wasn't getting love to begin with, but I feel like it gets unfairly pulled down with the other two, because I actually find this movie insanely good on rewatch. I actually don't have really any major complaints to it. I think the acting and the writing all around is a lot better. Hayden Christensen does really well. I don't understand why he got another Razzie. I mean, he's not great still. It's all around, it's 10 times better than the other two, but it's still not enough in some cases to make it normal. There's some really bad line delivery.
Anakin, you're breaking my heart.
Really loved the lightsaber duels throughout the entire prequel trilogy, and the highlight of this movie is, of course, the final duel between Obi-Wan and Anakin. I loved it so much, although I do think it goes a little overboard. Most of the little negatives I have are just kind of nitpicks. For the most part, I think this movie holds up a lot better than the other two with its CGI and stuff. For whatever reason, it just looks a lot better. Obviously, because there's a 3-year difference, too, between this one and Attack of the Clones, so. And the finale, between the kind of the cheesy dialogue, are some really good deliveries, and good dialogue is kind of mixed in there, so it's never like the whole scene's ruined, this sucks. It's like anytime there's a bad thing, there's something that comes right after it to redeem it. I don't know. I feel like I really liked it though, is the thing. So even though I have nitpicks, they're not like anything that push it down for me, because I think the movie's still really good. Solo and Rogue One. I actually watched Solo for the first time semi-recently. I passed on it because I heard so much bad about it. So when I watched it, I was surprised about how good it actually was. It wasn't good. I was surprised at how good it was compared to, I'd set my bar really low and it was actually decent. I don't know. I think the biggest issue I have with Solo is just that after I watched it, it's like all I could think about was this would have been really good if it came out in the mid to late 80s and starred Harrison Ford. Not that I hated his portrayal of Han Solo, because I think he did it different enough. Donald Glover was perfectly cast, I think, as Lando. The plot is fine. Like, I don't know. I guess I'm surprised that it came out as good as it did, considering that it went through a couple of directors. It went from, I think, the Wachowski brothers to Ron Howard, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know. It may have been somebody else, but I know Ron Howard finished it, but I don't exactly remember who it was originally. I may have had it right. I think watching it was fine. Like, I was surprised that it turned out as good as it was. But it's not a movie I don't think I would ever rewatch. And I don't really feel like I have to rewatch this movie. It was, I don't know. I think it's competent. I'll say it's better than Phantom Menace. If I had the choice between watching Phantom Menace and Solo, realistically, I'd probably still pick Phantom Menace. I don't know. It's fine. Moving on. Rogue One, the first time I watched it, I remember hating. Not hating, but being like kind of bored with it up until the end. I really liked the ending, thought it was really fun, but. And what's funny is that the major complaint I had this movie initially was the characters. Funny enough, I think I actually, rewatching, I actually liked the characters from this movie better than in the main sequel trilogy. They just feel like they've been through more, and I don't know, I liked the struggles they actually went through, because that's the one thing I don't feel like they have in the sequel trilogy was like real struggle, and I don't know if I'm making sense, but. Yeah, I actually really like this movie a lot more. I still think Star Wars is so big now that it could, I think The Mandalorian is a perfect example of that. It's big enough now it can branch off and do its own thing. It doesn't have to stay to the main story. It's like it's popular enough, you can branch off it and do your own story in Middle Earth. You can do your own story in the Star Wars universe and not have to branch it off and base it off of things that are already popular, which is my big thing with Solo. It's like, we don't need a Solo movie. We don't need a Boba Fett movie. Go off and do your own thing. Rogue One, at the very least, added something to the story, or I just spit, enough to where it made it necessary, I think. I don't know if I'd say it was necessary, but I think it added enough to the story that I enjoyed it. So what's funny is that Rogue One, which just came off as this random spinoff that I didn't like first when I watched it, I think it became my favorite movie in the sequel universe. I don't know if people will agree with me on that. I don't feel like very many will. I don't know the general opinion of this movie to begin with, but I think Rogue One's pretty good. To be fair, I still think the characters are forgettable, and I think the whole second act of this movie is just really boring and kind of slow, but I do feel like it picked up at the end. Anyways, yeah, let's go to the original trilogy, and I'm gonna plop both these down here. I won't say much about them other than the fact that they're freaking amazing movies that are just timeless. Like, growing up with them, it's like you can just rewatch these movies consistently and they still hold up so well. I think the thing that I love about these films is that you never feel like the Rebels are winning. I guess they technically win at the end of New Hope with destroying the Death Star, But then Empire Strikes Back comes out and they're back, you know, the Empire's back on top. So it's like, you feel that constant struggle. The Rebels are never truly winning until the end of Return of the Jedi is when, you know, you finally get like that conclusion. But that's what I love, is that it's like the Rebels are always the underdog against the Empire versus the First Order and the Resistance. Yeah, I don't know. I think the less said about these movies, the better. I don't mean to gloss over them, but they're just so good, man. Return of the Jedi, however, is my least favorite of the three. I still think it's a good movie. I love the beginning and I love the ending, but I don't understand why they brought Han Solo back. I know Harrison Ford was hoping they'd kill him off. I kind of wish they did, because I thought Empire Strikes Back would have been a good end to his character, if I'm being honest. But the whole middle part with like the Ewoks, and I don't know, it's not my thing. I remember not really liking it growing up, and I still, I don't know. I do love Mark Hamill in this film though, and how like overpowered he is. And I love seeing how he starts off in the first one. A lot of people called him whiny. I mean, it's really just that one scene, I think, when he's on Tatooine. After he gets off Tatooine, I don't remember him being a whiny character at all. But regardless of that, you see his start as that versus how he ends in Return of the Jedi. I'll put Return of the Jedi at A. The sequel trilogy. It's funny that the first one that came out, Force Awakens, was my favorite of the sequel trilogy. They did the smart thing. It's just remake A New Hope. I didn't hate it for that. I knew what they were doing. I knew why they did it. They were wanting to kind of appeal to what was familiar, but also reintroduce Star Wars to a new fan base. It was a smart idea. If anything, I don't think there's anything I legitimately hated about it. It's just kind of flat and kind of, it lacks a lot of rewatch value for me. Even when I first saw it, I don't think I ever really had the urge to rewatch it again. If there's anything I legitimately hated about it, was the ending when Rey beat Kylo Ren. It's so stupid. Like, she should have had some sort of, I mean, imagine if Luke fought Darth Vader at the end of New Hope. After Vader kills Obi-Wan, Luke picks up his lightsaber and then beats Darth Vader. That's the equivalent of this movie's end. It doesn't leave any room to progress. It's so weird, because at the end of this movie, it establishes that Rey is superior to Kylo Ren. So what's the other two movies gonna be? When it comes to The Last Jedi, a lot of people are split on it. I'm split on it, because there's a lot of things I hate about this movie. I hated the direction that Rian Johnson went with it. However, I actually liked some of the choices he made that I hated originally. Him killing off Snoke, for instance, sounded like the dumbest. I remember watching it being like, why'd he do that? Like, but I actually liked that he did that, because we didn't need Snoke. I didn't feel like we needed another Emperor stand-in. Like, let's do our own thing here. So I feel like Rian Johnson, in a lot of ways, he didn't progress a lot. In fact, a lot of things he just flat out messed up entirely, like killing off Luke Skywalker and the rest of the freaking... Okay, I'm not even going to talk about Finn's storyline or Rose, but the two things I actually liked about this film was that he killed off Snoke, and I actually liked the Rey and Kylo connection, and... or the Rey and Ben Solo, whatever. That connection, and then killing off Snoke. I actually liked those two things, or the two interesting things he did here, because it ended that off, and I felt like it would have led to a more interesting sequel with him being gone, there not being an Emperor replacement. Kylo Ren's now the main villain. Let's do something interesting with that. So I don't know. I hated it when I initially saw it, but I came to accept it and was like, you know what? Maybe this isn't actually a bad thing. I hated what he did with Luke Skywalker though. I hated the direction he went with him. I would have been okay with it if we had any sort of build up to it. I wish, and they would have never done this, but I really wish, looking back at it, that they would have not done The Force Awakens and not done The Last Jedi. Do two films where they did it like Solo. I know people are gonna freak when this happened, which is the reason why they wouldn't do it, because people, there'd be a complete backlash. I wish they would have just recast the original actors, do one or two movies that would have taken place right after Return of the Jedi, and then had the third film take place years later, bring back Mark Hamill, Carrie Fisher, and the rest of them to do one final film with them older. Now, we could have that build up to now see where Luke is, because I understand why he's there, but I wish you would have saw the progression. It was just, I don't know, I find Luke's backstory to where he began in this movie more interesting. Like, I wanted to see the stuff with Kylo Ren, and I feel like that would have been a more interesting movie. I don't know, I would have just much rather seen something to that extent. And I know they would have never done it, and I understand why they would have never done it, but looking back, I think that would have been cool if they had recast it, kind of did two movies building up to it. I think that would have been a more interesting sequel trilogy if we got to see something that took place right after Empire instead of what we got. But I think that's just me looking back on it. So I don't know, what's my opinion with this movie is I'm very mixed with it. There are some things I like about it, but there's way too many things that are just insufferable. The Finn and Rose storyline, all that stuff is horrible. None of the jokes landed for me. Even when I watched watched it in theater. My theater, I watched it with pretty much dead silent for most of the jokes, so it was kind of awkward. They didn't do anything interesting with Finn, which I hated, because I actually liked him in the first movie. I think he was the one character I really liked. And once again, this movie ends with a big resistance victory, and it's like, there's no downswing. Also, the movie just doesn't make any progress, but it is really pretty. So, while Last Jedi wasn't a good movie for me, in fact, I will go on a limb and say that I hated most things about it, I think The Last Jedi did a great job at setting up what could have been a great third film. I don't know if you guys ever read the Colin Trevorrow movie. You can't say anything because the movie doesn't exist, but reading what leaked, I can say that I really liked the direction that Colin Trevorrow went in, because he bridged off of The Last Jedi perfectly and kind of showed that you can do something completely unique here and not have to bring the Emperor back in to try and save the film, because there's no need to do that. I understand why J.J. Abrams felt the need to try and backpedal after the backlash of The Last Jedi, because to be fair, I don't love J.J. Abrams. I think he's made good movies before, but I think he's kind of overrated. If you had had good writers, I honestly think the third film could have been really good, and it would have made the other two films worthwhile, like the prequels. The first two films were not great, but Revenge of the Sith really saved the prequel trilogy, in my opinion. If I'm being honest, it's my least favorite Star Wars film, period, because there's not a single thing in there that made me interested at all. Phantom Menace had the Duel of the Fates, the final fight scene, versus Rise of Skywalker, which had Rey's yellow lightsaber, which I actually really liked. I'm a huge Knights of the Old Republic fan, and I love the yellow lightsaber, so Rey pulling out that yellow lightsaber was like, hey, this is the only time I smiled throughout the entire movie. I've watched the movie twice, and I still can't tell you anything about it. Like, it's such a forgettable movie. Okay, well, that's my ranking of the Star Wars films. I know it's popular to hate on the sequel trilogy, but I don't know. I think that The Force Awakens was the most complete of those three. The Last Jedi was a huge risk that, for the most part, did not pay off, in my opinion, but laid the groundwork for what could have been an amazing trilogy end, if they'd done it right. And from what I read from Duel of the Fates, I think it could have been it. But we got what we got. I did not like Rise of Skywalker at all. Maybe I'll warm up to it eventually. As of right now, I just don't feel like a lot of people enjoyed the sequel trilogy, and myself included. The original trilogy is easily the best because each movie is really good. The prequel trilogy is not great, but Revenge of the Sith was amazing and justified the other two. What's the word I'm looking for? It really saved the other two movies, because Phantom and Attack of the Clones, they're not good movies at all. They have their moments, but they're not good. Revenge of the Sith really did a lot to pull those out of the fire and make them work, I guess. The sequel trilogy just feels like it's unnecessary. The first movie is a soft reboot, and then it kind of goes into it, and The Last Jedi kind of tears a lot of stuff down, but sets up some interesting premises. So even though I didn't like The Last Jedi, it really set up for a great closer. And Rise of Skywalker just kind of backtracked over everything and gave us a movie that didn't need to exist with the Emperor and, I don't know, whatever the heck this movie was. I don't know. It's not good. I don't know if this is a popular opinion or not, but this is my opinion on the Star Wars series, so yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. The next video that comes out should be the Mob Psycho reaction with me and my sister. I don't know when that's coming out, but it'll be out soon, hopefully. And yeah, with all that being said, I will talk to y'all later. Peace out.